The goal of this video is to show the communication between an I/O link sensor and an Ethernet IP network. In this example, we will use a temperature sensor from IFM and integrate it into an Allen Bradley Compact Logix PLC using Studio 5000 Logix Designer software. In three steps, we will establish the connection between the I/O link master, PLC, and PC, then integrate the I/O link master with the Allen Bradley Studio 5000 software, and finally read the process value of a TD temperature sensor using IFM's add-on instructions. Before we start, here's a list of the necessary hardware and accessories. First, we need a notebook or PC with Studio 5000 Logix Designer software installed. Studio 5000 is the automation software from Allen Bradley. Besides, we need the following hardware: a PLC and an IFM I/O link master with Ethernet IP field bus interface and a temperature sensor. Last but not least, we need a power supply, Ethernet connection cables, and a connection cable for the sensor. In order to work with the controller, please do the following hardware setup as shown. Connect one of the upper Ethernet ports and the IoT port of the I/O link master to the switch and the switch to the PC via the Ethernet cables. The AL1322 is a data line I/O link master, which has two field bus Ethernet IP ports and one extra IoT port. This IoT port can be used for connecting the system with the IT world or for configuring the device. Now we can set the port addresses of the I/O link master and the address of the Ethernet port of the PC. Our controller has the IP address 192.168.1.100 and the subnet mask 3x255.0. We therefore configure the IP address of our PC and the I/O link master in such a way that all components are in the same network. Open the properties of the Ethernet adapter in the network and sharing center by right-clicking on the device. We set the IP address to 192.169.1.200 and use the same subnet mask. In the next step, we align the port address of our I/O link master. Open a browser and go to ifm.com. You only have to register once on the homepage and log in with your account. After that, you get free access to the download. Search for the Ethernet IP I/O link master. Here we use an AL1322. Go to the download section and scroll down. Download the IFM NetSetter tool and install the software on your PC. After starting the software, the scan button is used to search the entire network. As we have connected the field bus, as well as the IoT port, to the switch in our setup, both are detected by the software. In the following, we will connect the master to the controller via the field bus. This is why we set the field bus address to 192.168.1.130. and thus have brought all components into the same network. Please note that this free software is only used for IP address settings. For all other configurations, please check out IFM's Monio Configure software, which you can also find on our website. The Compact Logix PLC has two different Ethernet ports. One port is used to connect the Studio 5000 software. The other port is connected to the I/O link master. All connections are shown here in this example. The I/O link temperature sensor is connected to port number 5 of the master. It should be noted that the total power consumption must comply with the power rating of the power supply. Besides the hardware, we also need some software and auxiliary tools to make the whole process work. As mentioned earlier, Studio 5000 is the programming software for Allen Bradley PLCs. It brings the hardware and the software world together. The EDS file of AL1322 describes the I/O link master in the PLC. It adds the master to the module catalog in Studio 5000. To read the process data of an I/O link sensor, IFM supplies add-on instructions in the starter packages. Depending on the device, a function block is provided that shows all of the sensor's process values after configuration. For the calculation of the process value, a gradient is also required, which can vary from one sensor to another. This information can be found in the IODD PDF of the temperature sensor used. In order to configure the IO Link Master in Studio 5000, we have to install its EDS file first. This file and other useful tools can be found in the starter package of the IO Link Master. We select the Allen Bradley package. We have already downloaded the package and are now ready to install the required file. In the Studio 5000 software, you will find the EDS hardware installation tool under the Tools tab at the top. Follow the wizard. And select the file for the IO Link Master used from the EDS folder in the starter package. Once the file is installed, we can implement it in our software. Right-click on the Ethernet adapter to which we are connected and add a new module. Use the search bar to navigate to the AL1322. In the module properties, we enter the IP address of the master that we have previously set. We choose and assign the name Generic AL1322 for our IO Link master. We also change the data type from short integer to integer to be able to work with a 16-bit. Instead of an 8-bit view. When all settings are confirmed, the module is added on the left side. Once we have downloaded the program, we can go online and see that everything is operational. If this is not the case, please check the settings again. The last step is to read out the data from our IO Link sensor. Navigate to the add-on instruction on the left, right-click, and select Import. An add-on instruction is a predefined function block that is easy to configure and makes the usage of IO Link data very convenient. They can be used for the input and output of process data, as well as configuration settings. In the already downloaded startup package, we now select the according instruction for our TD2833 temperature sensor. To do so, select Add-on and IFM Devices, pick the device family folder TD TATP, and select the instruction for our AL1322 8-port IO Link Master. After the import is complete, we go to our main routine and add the instruction via drag and drop. To parameterize the block, we start by giving the instruction a unique name. Select our IO Link Master's input array. Choose your IO Link Master colon I1.data to read the data from the sensor at port number 5. Vendor and device ID belong to the output data of the sensor, just like the temperature value. The only difference here is that vendor and device ID are fixed values that are assigned by the manufacturer. The temperature value, of course, is a variable process value. Last but not least, we need to check if the preset gradient for calculating the temperature value is correct. This information can be found in the IODD PDF of the sensor. This file can be found in the download area of the TD2833 on the IFM homepage. Scroll down and open the IO Link device description, or short IODD. On page number 1, you will find general information such as the vendor and device ID. 310 is the vendor ID for IFM, and 376 is the device ID for the TD2833 temperature sensor we use. This document also contains information on the process data structure of the sensor and the gradient we need. In our case, this is already the default value. We now can go online and start reading data from the sensor. As expected, the value in the Studio 5000 software is matching the value on the display of our temperature sensor. Thanks for watching. There are other videos on the subject of sensor technology from IFM that may be of interest to you.